نحمده ونصلي على رسوله الكريم أما بعد Almighty Allah تبارك وتعالى tells us about a conversation that had taken place between him and the Malaika with regards to the creation of mankind. Allah tabarak wa ta'ala tells us, وَإِذْ قَالَ رَبُّكَ لِلْمَلَائِكَةِ إِنِّي جَاعِلٌ فِي الْأَرْضِ خَلِيفَةً that Allah tabarak wa ta'ala wanted to create mankind. Allah tabarak wa ta'ala told the angels that I am going to create a khalifa or a vicegerent on earth. Allah tabarak wa ta'ala wanted to see what the malaika are going to say and what they are going to respond. And Allahu alam, Allah knew ahead of time what the malaika are going to say. The malaika said, أَتَجْعَلُ فِيهَا مَنْ يُفْسِدُ فِيهَا وَيَفْسِكُ الدِّمَاءَ that are you going to create such a creation that is going to spread mischief on earth and is going to spread blood, is going to spill blood? Upon that Allah tabarak wa ta'ala says, إِنِّي أَعْلَمُ مَا لَا تَعْلَمُونَ I know that which you do not know. Almighty Allah tabarak wa ta'ala, his ilm is so comprehensive. He knows each and everything. But in spite of that, before creating mankind, Allah tabarak wa ta'ala told the malaika about it. And he wanted the response of the malaika. The commentator of the Quran mentioned that this was one form of mashwara which Allah tabarak wa ta'ala has made with the malaika. Although Allah tabarak wa ta'ala is not in need of the mashwara of anyone, mashwara generally is made when a person doesn't know, when a person is doubtful. There's not a single thing that Allah doesn't know, and there's not a single thing that Allah is doubtful about. But in spite of that, Allah tabarak wa ta'ala made mashwara with the malaika. He didn't just go and create mankind. Malaika were created before that. But Allah tabarak wa ta'ala has made mashwara with the malaika. And one of the wisdoms of making mashwara with the malaika is that they would also feel happy. Unki dil jo ho jayegi, they will be happy about it. From this we understand what is the importance of mashwara. When Allah tabarak wa ta'ala is not in need of any guidance, Allah tabarak wa ta'ala has no doubt on any issue, he knows everything. In spite of that, before creating mankind, Allah tabarak wa ta'ala discussed the matter with the malaika. This shows to us and expresses to us the importance of mashwara. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is the Prophet of Allah. He was a recipient of revelation. He was getting wahi. He also didn't need to make mashwara with anyone. If he required any guidance, he could simply turn to Allah tabarak wa ta'ala. And no sooner would Allah tabarak wa ta'ala send Jibreel alayhi salatu wa salam with guidance. In spite of that, Allah tabarak wa ta'ala tells to Nabiya Kareem sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, وَشَاوِرْهُمْ فِي الْأَمْرِ you've got the Sahaba around you, and on many issues, make mashwara with them as well. And that is why in tonight's Taraweeh, where we recited Surah Shura, Allah tabarak wa ta'ala discusses an outstanding quality of the Muslimin, that their matter is such that they decide based on mashwara and mutual consultation. They don't decide on issues unilaterally and all by themselves. They see what is best in the interest of the matter, and this is based on maswara and discussing with one another. When we look into the life of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, so many instances he has made maswara with the Sahaba. During the battle of Uhud, Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam had to make maswara with the Sahaba. During the battle of Badr, when they had to go out of Madinah Munawwara and engage with the Kuffar, Nabi Kareem sallallahu alaihi wasallam made maswara with the Sahaba there as well. During the battle of Ahzab, when all the Muslims, non-Muslims, they decided to unite and once and for all launch a collective attack on the Muslims, Nabi Kareem sallallahu alaihi wasallam, they again made maswara. He asked different Sahaba what to do. Hazrat Salman radiallahu ta'ala anhu told Nabi Kareem sallallahu alaihi wasallam, O Prophet of Allah, when we in Persia, we are faced with a situation like this and we cannot defend the enemy, we would dig trenches and we would avoid the advancement of the enemy to our land. Nabi Kareem sallallahu alaihi wasallam accepted the maswara of Salman radiallahu ta'ala anhu and he told the Sahaba to dig the trench. And this is what we know as Ghazwa-e Ahzab, although no war had taken place, but Nabi Kareem sallallahu alaihi wasallam being a recipient of revelation, wahi comes down to Nabi Kareem sallallahu alaihi wasallam, but Nabi Kareem sallallahu alaihi wasallam made mashwara with the Sahaba. When the year after that Nabi Kareem sallallahu alaihi wasallam saw a dream that he is in Madinah Munawwara, he and the Sahaba, they are in the state of Ihram and they are removing the hair. Nabi Kareem sallallahu alaihi wasallam mentioned this to the Sahaba and the Sahaba were very happy. It was a long time that they had come from Makkah Mukarramah, years of past time. They were born and brought up in Makkah Mukarramah. They were so attached to the Kaaba Sharif that they were looking forward for the day when they would go back to Makkah Mukarramah and make tawaf of the Baytullah. Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam just mentioned this dream to the Sahaba and immediately they all were ready to make Umrah. They thought that and they knew that the dream of Nabi Kareem sallallahu alaihi wasallam is true. But what was not mentioned in the dream is that when will they be making the tawaf and when they will be making the Umrah. Nevertheless, they went. It was during this safar, in the sixth year after Hijrat, that the Kuffar stopped Nabi Kareem sallallahu alaihi wasallam and the Sahaba from going to Makkah Mukarramah. And they told, come the following year, and they set certain terms and conditions which Nabi Kareem sallallahu alaihi wasallam accepted, and then the following year Umratul Qadha was made. During this safar, when the Kuffar stopped Nabi sallallahu alaihi wasallam and the Sahaba from making Umrah, Sahaba was very, very upset. Nabi Kareem sallallahu alaihi wasallam told the Sahaba that let's come out from the Ihram, we'll go back to Madinah Munawwara and we'll come the following year. Sahaba generally would listen to everything that Nabi Kareem sallallahu alaihi wasallam would say. But here they were firm and they really wanted to make Umrah. They fell hard to remove the Ihram. Umar radiallahu ta'ala finally said to the Nabi Kareem sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, O Prophet of Allah, are we on haq or are they on haq? Nabi Kareem sallallahu alayhi wa sallam mentioned, we are on haq. Umar radiallahu ta'ala said, when we were not on haq, when we were on batil, we were so firm and we were so steadfast, nobody could overrule us. Today, we are on haq, and how come our enemies can overrule us? Nabi Kareem sallallahu alayhi wa sallam did not say anything. He goes in a tent and he discusses the matter with Umm Salma radiallahu ta'ala anha. And he says that Sahaba, they are so firm and strong on making Umrah. And I have accepted and consented to the terms and conditions of the disbelievers to go back to Madinah Munawwara and come the following year. Umme Salma radiallahu ta'ala, a woman with lots of insight, she said to Nabi Kareem sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was in the state of ihram. She said to Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam that if you want everyone to come out from the ihram, it is very simple. You first go out and you go and shave your hair out. And the moment you shave your hair and you come out of the ihram, then the Sahaba will have no option but to follow you. Immediately Nabi Kareem sallallahu alayhi wa took that bite of Umme Salma radiallahu ta'ala, went out of the tent, removed the hair and took out the ihram. All the Sahaba saw what Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa had done, and immediately they also removed the hair and they came out of the ihram. This was the mashwara that was given by the wife of Nabi Kareem sallallahu alayhi wa sallam to Nabi Kareem sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, that has helped to solve the problem at that time. When Nabi Kareem sallallahu alayhi wa sallam passed away, after the demise of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, there was a big war that took place, Jang-e-Yamama. And there was an imposter, Musaylama Kazzab. He claimed prophethood. In fact, during the time of Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he sent a message to Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and said, O Prophet of Allah, O Muhammad, that Prophet of Allah, he said that I want to get into an agreement with you. That one is that you take control of the cities and I take control of the towns, of the small villages. And upon you leaving the world, then I will take your position. Something to that effect. Nabi Kareem sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he had a small stick in his hand. And he said, even if you want a share in this stick too, I won't give you a share in this. After the demise of Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, when Musaylama Kazzab raised his head and he claimed prophethood, Sahaba went into a war with him. And many, many Sahaba were killed in this war. There were many of them who were Qurra, Huffaz, and many of their lives were taken away. It was at this time and point that Umar radiallahu ta'ala anhu, he came to Abu Bakr Siddiq radiallahu ta'ala and said, Oh Abu Bakr, the Quran right now is in the hearts of the Huffaz. The Quran wasn't compiled at that time. Quran ka wo sahifa bana hua nahi tha. It wasn't compiled. It was in the heart of the Sahaba. Yes, individual Sahaba, they had their own writings. Everybody has their own small collection, but it wasn't officially collected and compiled. So Umar radiallahu ta'ala came to Abu Bakr Siddiq radiallahu ta'ala and said, see what happened here in this war. So many Huffaz went, so many Qurra went, and all of them have passed away. And like that, if many more wars have to take place, Allah knows that how many Huffaz will be taken away from the dunya, and we could lose a great portion of the Quran. So why don't you compile the Quran? Abu Bakr Siddiq radiallahu ta'ala said that I never can do a thing which Nabi Kareem sallallahu alayhi wa sallam never did and never told us to do. Mujhe himmat nahi hai. Jab Nabi Kareem sallallahu alayhi wa sallam ne usko nahi kiya, Quran ko jama nahi kiya, aur na jama karne ka hukam diya, mere andar jama karne ki himmat nahi hai. Main nahi kar sakta. Umar radiallahu ta'ala goes away. Again Umar radiallahu ta'ala come and give the same mashwara. And he tells Abu Bakr Siddiq, please do this. I've got sharaf sabr about this. And again and again, Umar radiallahu kept on giving this maswara to Abu Bakr Siddiq radiallahu ta'ala, until Abu Bakr Siddiq radiallahu ta'ala got sharaf sabr. Then what Umar radiallahu ta'ala saying is correct and true. That is when Abu Bakr Siddiq radiallahu ta'ala now also felt that the Quran Kareem should be compiled. This is with the maswara of Umar radiallahu ta'ala. They called Zayd ibn Thabit radiallahu ta'ala. He was a Qatib and he was a scribe at the time of Nabi Kareem sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So Abu Bakr Siddiq and Umar radiallahu ta'ala told to Zayd ibn Thabit that you are a young person and you are an Amin, Diyanadar person, trustworthy person. Nabi Kareem sallallahu alayhi wa sallam trusted you. Wahi used to come down and he used to write the Wahi down. So we want you to compile the Quran Kareem. We don't find anybody as suitable as yourself. And Abu Bakr Siddiq told to Zayd ibn Thabit, your Umar came to me again and again and again. I didn't have satisfaction until now I got Shari Sadr that we should compile the Quran Kareem. Zayd ibn Thabit said, I can never do a thing which Nabi Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam didn't do. What was the initial response of Abu Bakr Siddiq to Umar radiallahu ta'ala anhu was the response of Zayd ibn Thabit to Abu Bakr Siddiq radiallahu ta'ala anhu. Unhone bhi yahi jawab diya. Until they kept on telling him, like how Umar kept on telling to Abu Bakr Siddiq, now Abu Bakr and Umar radiallahu anhu kept on telling the same thing to Zayd ibn Thabit. Until Zayd ibn Thabit also got itminan e qalb, satisfaction and contentment of the heart, and he felt that what they do want to do, that is correct, and he went and he compiled the Quran Kareem. All this was done with the barakat of Mashwara. And again, when you look into the lives of the Sahaba, so many places, important issues, they made Mashwara. Once, Umar radiallahu ta'ala anhu, he happened to go to Syria, to Sham. And there was a war that took place there, and they required Umar radiallahu ta'ala to come there. And then it's famous, the name of the place is Autas, called Ghazwa-e Autas. So, when they came there, came to a border of Syria, a plague had broken out. Waba phail gayi, a plague. And many, many Sahaba were dying and passing away in that plague. Now it is mentioned in the hadith, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam did say that agar kisi jagah waba phail jaye, if any place a plague breaks out, don't go there. And if you are in a place where a plague broke out, ab wahan se nikle mat. Wherever there is a plague broke out, and if you are inside, then you mustn't come out either. And that too with the intention of running away from death. So, when Umar radiallahu anhu came to the border of Syria, and the Amir of that time, Ghaliban Abu Ubaidah ibn Jarrah radiallahu ta'ala anhu, informed Umar radiallahu ta'ala anhu ko dekhe, yahan to waba phail gayi, aur aapke andar mein jana khatra hai. So, Umar radiallahu ta'ala immediately, he didn't just decide on himself what to do. He made maswara. He asked, called some young sahaba, he asked them what to do. They gave one maswara. He called others, they gave another maswara. Until he called the senior sahaba, the senior muhajirin, to bare bare log hai, to unko bulaya. Aur aam taur par, aisi cheezo ke andar mein baro ki maswara ki zarurat hoti hai. The elders, what advice and what wisdom they got, choto ke andar mein nahi hota hai. Aam taur par you see, hum bhi chote hai, magar aam taur par, when it comes to making maswara big, big issues, it is nice ke baro ka maswara liya jaye. Unke andar mein zindagi ka tajruba hai. Aur tajruba ke natije mein jo baat samne aati hai, usse bari khair aur barakat hoti hai. So, Abu Bakr Siddiq r.a. called all the elderly muhajirin and asked them what must do. So they said, dekho, so you are there, you've also got great great sahaba with you. Agar aap andar mein chale gaye aur khuda na khasta, agar waba aapko lag gayi, then you probably will go and great great sahaba will go. And there's a need for your presence in the ummah at this stage. There's a need of the great sahaba that's around you, there's a need for them. So our right and our maswara is that you should go back. Go back to Madina Munawara, aap andar ke andar na chale jaye. This was he did with maswara. So Abu Ubaidah ibn Jarrah radiallahu ta'ala told to Umar radiallahu ta'ala anhu that sab kuch muqaddar hai, everything will be taqdeer. If you have to go inside and if you die, it will be taqdeer. And if you don't go inside and if you die, it will be still with taqdeer. Aap yahan se kyun bhag rahe hai? That's what Abu Ubaidah ibn Jarrah told Umar radiallahu ta'ala anhu. Umar radiallahu ta'ala bahut behtareen jawab diya. He gave a beautiful example. He said that see, if there is a pasture and it's very green, and one to a pasture is not green, it is dry. If the animal has to graze on the green pasture, how it will graze there? Isn't with the order of Allah? And if he is to grave on a dry pasture, it will grave also with the order of Allah. He said, yes. Then Umar radiallahu ta'ala said, we are not running away from death. What we are doing is that نَحْنُ نَفِرُّ مِنَ اللَّهِ تَعَالَىٰ إِلَى اللَّهِ تَعَالَىٰ, that we are running away from Allah to Allah, which means if we are going inside with the order of Allah, and if we are going to Madinah Munawwara, we are not running away from Allah, we are going to Madinah also with the order of Allah, because Allah knew what is going to happen. So this is all maswara that even Abu Umar radiallahu ta'ala and great sahaba have done. So this is something that we should not lose sight of in our own personal zindagi. In our own life, always do things with mashwara. How often it happens, we make big decisions, sometimes as children, sometimes as students, or sometimes as parents, sometimes as husbands, sometimes as wives. That we make such decisions without mashwara, as a result, we suffer the consequences, bhugatna padta hai. How often we make decisions and then we tell it to somebody, so aaj ye kyun kiya, aap mujhe pehle bata de, dusra mashwara aapko deta, khaan wo khaan nuksan ho jata hai. So why we have to do that? Rather make mashwara ahead of time to save yourself from nuksan. Allah ne jab nuksan se bachne ka raasta bataya, to hum khaan wo khaan kyun nuksan ke andar mubtala hote hain. Allah showed us how to avoid nuksan. Why must we put ourselves in the nuksan? And one way is by making mashwara. So many people got inside, so many people got hikmah and wisdom, consult with them so that we could save ourselves from nuksan, we could save ourselves from any possible harm. However, it is mentioned in one hadith, Nabi Kareem sallallahu alayhi wa sallam did mention that although some of the muhaddithin made kalam on this hadith, but whatever the ma'ani and the mafhoom of this hadith is well established, Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam mentioned, ma khaba man istakhar wa ma nadima man istashar. That person who made maswara, unko kabhi nadamat nahi hoti hai. You make maswara, and after maswara, agar maswara koi zahiri nuksan ho gaya, then you can't do anything about it. Hum keh sakte hai ki bas maswara kiya aur hum kya kar sakte the. Fir uske baad agar nuksan ho, you can say, okay, right, you tried and you failed, you rather try and fail than failing to try. And then fir uske baad you make maswara, do whatever you're supposed to do. Faida azamta fatawakkal Allah. Now you make a firm intention, you leave that tawakkul in the hand of Allah tabarak wa ta'ala. But don't avoid making mashwara, or don't discard making mashwara. In one hadith, Nabi Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam also mentioned, after mashwara sometimes, you still not certain, make istikhara. And with mashwara and istikhara, if you follow this pattern in life, then so many things of our life will be able to make a correct and appropriate decision. Allah's guidance will definitely come. If you follow the Quran, you follow the Hadith, you follow the advice given to us by Nabi Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, how to make decisions, then it's very unlikely that we will suffer a loss. And okay, one more aspect of our mashwara is that when first it mentioned the Hadith, Al-Mustashar Mu'tamanun. When you're taking mashwara, when somebody is asking you mashwara, then you are an Amin. You're a trustworthy person. Jo aapne mashwara talab kare, sachi pakki baat unko bata dena chahiye, koi baat chupani nahi chahiye. And that is your mashwara. Magar, and that is in mashwara, whatever you divulge and whatever you say, that will not be regarded to be ghibat and backbiting. Because somebody is asking you, maybe about a person, or maybe about something else. So whatever reality of the situation you present to a person, because a person has to make a decision. آپ ہی نہیں کہہ سکتے اچھا فلانے کے بارے میں اگر کوئی بات ہوگی غیبت ہو جائے گی, بٹ دس دا پرسن از آسکنگ یو اف یو نوٹ گوئنگ ٹو ٹاک اباؤٹ اے پرٹیکولر پرسن, ناٹ ود دا انٹینشن آف بیلٹلنگ ہم, تنقید مقصود نہیں ہے, بلکہ یہاں آدمی کی رہنمائی کی ضرورت ہے. دیٹس وائی یو اٹینڈ دا ریالٹی آف دا سچویشن. سو دیٹ از اے غیبت. ان فیکٹ یو شوڈ سے اٹ, ادروائز دیٹ ود بی مس لیڈنگ دا پرسن, اینڈ دا پرسن کڈ بی ڈیسیوڈ بیکاز آف ناٹ ہیونگ دا کریکٹ انفارمیشن. So when a person asks you for maswara, try to give them the haqiqat of the situation, the reality of the situation, and let the person decide from there. That is why Nabi Sallallahu mentioned, Al-Mustashar Mu'tabarun. The person from whom you are taking maswara, he is an Amin. He is a reliable person, trustworthy person. It is expected of him to tell everything that he knows in relating to a particular situation. And one woman, Hazrat Fatima bint Qais radiallahu ta'ala anha. This hadith is mentioned in Bukhari, in the second volume in Kitab al-Talaq and other books of hadith as well. She was divorced from her husband. And when she was divorced, then after her iddah finished off, she got proposals from different Sahaba. She came to Nabiya Kareem sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and she said, O Prophet of Allah, I've got proposals from two Sahaba. Now these are Sahaba of Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, so beloved to Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Or aap mujhe mashwara de, whose proposal am I accepting? So Nabi Kareem sallallahu alayhi wa sallam bilkul sahi baat kehti, isliye ke shaadi ka masla hai. He can't say, acha acha, mere sahaba hai, and he just cited them as but shaadi kar lo. He didn't just say that. It's not a matter of contact. The contact ka masla nahi hai, balki aadmi ki zindagi ka masla hai. So Nabi Kareem sallallahu alayhi wa sallam then told to Fatima bint Qais, took the sahabi of one sahabi, he said, fasu'lu, bahut ghareeb aadmi. And then for regarding the other one, he said that he doesn't leave his stick. Uska matlab ye hai, ye nahi ke marte hai. Balki it means that he makes lots of suffer. So usse behtar ye hai ke Nabi sallallahu alaihi wasallam suggested get married to Usama radiallahu ta'ala. And that's how the nikah took place between Usama, the son of Zayd radiallahu ta'ala anhu, and with Fatima bint Qais radiallahu ta'ala anha. And this joy was a very, very happy joy. So here, Nabi Kareem sallallahu alaihi wasallam also gave mashwara. He gave the reality of the situation. When anybody asks us for mashwara, we give them haqiqah, proper advice and guidance. So this is one thing that we should do in our life, that anything, sometimes it could be a small issue, it could be a big issue, any issue of our life that we are not sure about, logo se mashwara kar lena chahe, and make mashwara with appropriate people. You don't see that you just go make mashwara with anyone. For example, if let's say it comes to regarding a matter about operating on a person, on the heart. Say, but operation karna chahe, operation nahi karna chahe. Jaake ke mufti sahab se pooch lo. Ab maine keh diya ke bhai operation mat karo. Phir and what will happen after that? But aur bhi nuksan hoga. They don't think, bhai, ki se mashwara diya mufti. You think it's because you took the mashwara from the wrong person. You think medical ke baare mein, to doctor se mashwara karna chahe. Or, for example, when you come to engineering, you go to engineering, you go to a doctor. Doctor ko injection ke baad baalum hai. Wo engineering ke andar mein injection ke baad mein hoti hai. So take mashwara from appropriate people, people who know the issue. And they will be able to advise and they will be able to guide on what is the best thing to do in that particular issue. We make dua that Allah Tabarak will give us the opportunity to understand and also take, follow all the advices and guidance that Shariah has given us. Wa akhir da'wana alhamdulillahi rabbil alamin. Bismillahir rahmanir rahim. اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد وعلى آل سيدنا محمد وبارك وسلم. اللهم أنت السلام ومنك السلام. تبارك ربنا وتعاليت يا ذا الجلال والإكرام. ربنا هب لنا من أزواجنا وذرياتنا قرة أعين واجعلنا للمتقين إماما. اللهم إنك عفو تحب العفو فاعف عنا. اللهم إنك عفو تحب العفو فاعف عنا. اللهم إنك عفو تحب العفو فاعف عنا. ربنا ظلمنا أنفسنا وإن لم تغفر لنا وترحمنا لنكونن من الخاسرين. اللهم إنا نتوب إليك من المعاصي كلها ولا نرجع إليها أبدا ولا نرجع إليها أبدا. اللهم تحرر قلوبنا من النفاق وأعمالنا من الرياء وألسنتنا من الكذب وأعيننا من الخيانة فإنك تعلم خائنة الأعين وما تخفي الصدور. رب ارحمهما كما ربياني صغيرا. رب ارحمهما كما ربياني صغيرا. اللهم اغفر لحينا وميتنا وشاهدنا وغائبنا وصغيرنا وكبيرنا وذكرنا وأنسانا. اللهم من أحييته منا فأحيه على الإسلام ومن توفيته منا فتوفه على الإيمان. اے پاک پروردگار تیرے فضل و کرم سے ہمارے تمام گناہوں کو معاف فرما دے. اے اللہ بہت ہی گنہگار ہے. اے اللہ ہم افسوس کر رہے ہیں, ندامت کر رہے ہیں, پوری زندگی تیری نافرمانی کے اندر میں گزری ہے. اے اللہ یہ ماہ رمضان ہے. یا اللہ یہ 21ویں رات ہے. یا اللہ ہم تجھ سے بھیک مانگ رہے ہیں. اے اللہ تیرے فضل و کرم سے ہمارے تمام گناہوں کو معاف فرما دے. اے اللہ ہمارے ماں باپ کے گناہوں کو معاف فرما دے. اے اللہ جو زندہ ہے ان کی بھرپور مغفرت فرما دے, جو انتقال کر چکے ہیں ان کی مغفرت فرما کر کے ان کے قبر کے اندر میں وسعت اور کشادگی یا اللہ پیدا فرما دے. یا اللہ تمام گناہوں کو معاف فرما دے, جو کسی قسم کے گناہ ہم نے کیے ہیں یا اللہ تیرے فضل و کرم سے تو ہمیں معاف فرما دے. یا اللہ ہم پختہ عہد کرتے ہیں کہ ہم آئندہ گناہ نہیں کریں گے. یا اللہ عہد کے اندر میں استقامت اور پختگی نصیب فرما دے. یا اللہ آئندہ گناہوں سے پورے طور پر تو ہمیں بچا دے. یا اللہ شریعت کے پابند تو ہمیں بنا دے. یا اللہ نماز کے پابند تو ہمیں بنا دے. شریعت کے احکام کی تعمیل کی توفیق یا اللہ تو ہمیں نصیب فرما دے. ہمیں خصوص اللہ کے اللہ تو نصیب فرما دے. یا اللہ تمام کے تمام گناہوں کو معاف فرما دے. یا اللہ جو گناہ ہم نے قصد کیے, ہمیں معلوم تھا کہ وہ غلط ہے, اس کے باوجود یا اللہ ہم نے جرأت کر کے وہ گناہ کیے ہیں. یا اللہ ہم نے بہت بڑی جرأت کی ہے. یا اللہ تیرے فضل و کرم سے معاف فرما دے. یا اللہ جو گناہ ہم نے نسیان کیے اس کو معاف فرما. جو بڑے بڑے گناہ, چھوٹے چھوٹے گناہ, یہ اے اللہ تیرے بلند شان کے مطابق کوئی گناہ چھوٹا نہیں. یا اللہ تو کتنا بڑا ہے. یا اللہ چھوٹی سی چھوٹی چیز تیرے بلند شان کے مطابق بہت بڑی ہے. یا اللہ تو ہمیں معاف فرما دے. یا اللہ بے ادبی کو معاف فرما دے, گستاخی کو معاف فرما دے. یا اللہ ہم تجھ سے مانگ رہے ہیں. یا اللہ تو ہمیں معاف فرما دے. یا اللہ یہ ماہ رمضان ہے, رحمت کا مہینہ ہے, آخری عشرہ ہے. یا اللہ تیری رحمت برس رہی ہے اس مجمع کے اندر میں. یا اللہ سفید ریش اور عمر رسیدہ حضرات ہیں. یا اللہ چھوٹے چھوٹے بچے بھی ہیں. یا اللہ تیرے فضل و کرم سے ان کی لاز فرما کر کے ہمارے گناہوں کو معاف فرما دے. یا اللہ تو ہمارے کمی اور کمزوریوں کو مت دیکھ. یا اللہ تو ہماری تیری نظر رحمت کی طرف دیکھنے کو دیکھ کر کے یا اللہ تو ہمیں فرما دے. فرما دے اللہ تمام امت کے حال پر رحم فرما دے. اللہ نبی صلی اللہ علیہ وسلم امتی جہاں کہیں بھی ہو, ان کی جان کی, ان کی مال کی, ان کی عزت کی, ان کے آبرو کی اللہ تو بھرپور حفاظت فرما دے. ان کے بھرپور مغفرت فرما دے. ظاہری باطنی فتنوں سے اللہ تو ان کو بچا دے. اللہ ہر قسم کی برائیوں سے پورے طور پر اللہ تو بچا دے. اللہ ہم میں سے جو مقروض ہے یا اللہ ان کے قرض کی ادائیگی کے لیے بہترین شکلیں غیب سے تو پیدا فرما دے. یا اللہ جو جاب کے اندر میں کسی قسم کی پریشانی میں ہے یا اللہ ان کی پریشانی کو یا اللہ تو دور فرما دے. یا اللہ جو بیمار ہے تو مکمل شفا نصیب فرما دے. یا اللہ جس بھائی نے آ کر کے یا اللہ گزارش کی کہ ان کی والدہ بیمار ہے, یا اللہ ان کے والدہ کو مکمل شفا نصیب فرما دے. یا اللہ تمام کے ہاتھ پر ہم فرما دے. یا اللہ جس کی جو بھی ضرورت ہو یا اللہ تو ان کے کو جانتا ہے. یا اللہ جو جائز ضروریات ہے کہ اللہ کے فضل و کرم سے اس کو پوری فرما دے. یا اللہ نیک جس کو نیک اولاد کی ضرورت ہے, نیک اولاد ان کو نصیب فرما دے. جن کے گھروں کے اندر میں جوان لڑکیاں ہیں شادی کے لائق, بہترین جوڑ ان کو نصیب فرما دے. یا اللہ جو بے اولاد ہے, اولاد صالح نصیب فرما دے. یا اللہ ہمارے بچوں کی طرف یا اللہ توجہ کی توفیق ہمیں نصیب فرما دے. ان کو حفاظ اور علماء بنا دے, نیک صالح متقی پرہیزگار ان کو بنا دے. دنیا کے فتنوں سے یا اللہ ان کو بچا دے. یا اللہ ہمیں ان کی تربیت کرنے میں ہم سے جو کمی اور کوتاہی ہو گئی اور ہو رہی ہے, یا اللہ تو ہمیں معاف فرما دے. ان کی طرف متوجہ ہونے کی توفیق یا اللہ تو ہمیں نصیب فرما دے. یا اللہ یہ ماہ رمضان کتنا جلدی گزر رہا ہے. یا اللہ اب چند ایام باقی ہے. یا اللہ تیری رحمت سے ہمیں محروم نہ فرمانا. یا اللہ اگر ہم محروم ہو گئے تو ہم سے زیادہ شقی اور بد نصیب کوئی نہیں ہوگا. یا اللہ تیرے فضل و کرم سے اور محض تیرے فضل و کرم سے یا اللہ اس میں نہ ہمارے اعمال کا دخل ہے, نہ ہمارے روزوں کا دخل ہے, نہ ہماری تلاوت کا دخل ہے. سب کچھ ناقص, ہم بھی ناقص. یا اللہ محض تیرے فضل و کرم سے یا اللہ تو ہمیں معاف فرما دے. یا اللہ تو ہمیں محروم نہ فرمانا, تو ہمیں محروم نہ فرمانا. یا اللہ تو ہمیں حسن خاتمہ نصیب فرما. یا اللہ موت کے وقت اللہ تو ہمیں یا اللہ ذلیل نہ فرمانا. یا اللہ عزت والی موت نصیب فرمانا, عزت والی موت نصیب فرمانا, ایسی موت نصیب فرما جس میں ہم تیری اطاعت و فرما برداری کے اندر میں مشغول رہے. یا اللہ ایسی موت نصیب فرمانا کہ ہم نماز پڑھنے والے ہو, ایسی موت نصیب فرمانا کہ ہم قرآن کریم کی تلاوت کر رہے ہو. یا اللہ یا دینی تعلیم کے اندر میں مشغول ہے, ایسی موت کے اللہ تو ہمیں نصیب فرمانا. یا اللہ اس بار ذلت کی جگہوں سے ہمیں بچا دے, گناہ کی جگہوں سے یا اللہ تو ہمیں بچا دے. یا اللہ ہمارے دلوں کو پاک صاف فرما دے. یا اللہ ہمارے ذریعے سے اگر کسی مسلمان کو کسی قسم کی کوئی تکلیف ہوئی ہو یا اللہ, اور یقیناً ہوئی ہے, یا اللہ ہم تو نہایت کمزور ہے اور ہم سب سے بہت سارے لوگوں کو تکلیف ہوتی ہے. یا اللہ ہمارے ذریعے سے جس کو تکلیف ہوئی ہو یا اللہ ان کو بہترین اجر ہمارے طرف سے تیرے برن شان کے مطابق نصیب فرما دے. اگر ان کے مغفرت, اگر ان کے انتقال ہو چکا ان کی قبر کے اندر میں مغفرت فرما کر کے ان کے درجات کو یا اللہ تو بلند فرما دے. یا اللہ, یا اللہ ہمارے ہم دنیا کے اندر اس حالت میں اٹھانا کہ ہمارے ذمے کسی کا کوئی قرض یا کسی کا کوئی حق نہ ہو. یا اللہ ہمیں دوسرے کو سے سر سے نظر کرنے کی توفیق اللہ تو نصیب فرما دے. یا اللہ, یا اللہ عذاب قبر سے تو ہمیں بچانا, آخر کے عذاب سے یا اللہ تو ہمیں بچانا. یا اللہ تیرے دربار کے اندر میں جب حاضری ہو یا اللہ, یا اللہ تو ہمیں معاف فرما. اللهم حاسبنا حساب يسيرا, اللهم حاسبنا حساب يسيرا, اللهم حاسبنا حساب يسيرا. اے اللہ تو ہمیں جنت کے اندر داخلہ بغیر حساب کے عنایت فرما. اے اللہ جنت کے اعلیٰ سے اعلیٰ مقام نصیب فرما دے. یا اللہ نبی کریم صلی اللہ علیہ کی مبارک ہاتھوں سے حوض کوثر کا جام یا اللہ کی نصیب فرما دے. یا اللہ تو ہمیں حرمین شریفین کی بار بار زیارت عنایت فرما دے. یا اللہ بار بار ہمیں حج کی, عمرہ کی, اور اللہ اور حرمین شریفین کی زیارت عنایت فرما. حرمین شریفین کی اللہ کی حفاظت فرما. امت مسلمہ کی ہار پر رحم فرما. یا اللہ ہم سے خوش ہو جا, راضی ہو جا. یا اللہ ہمیں لیلۃ القدر نصیب فرما. لیلۃ القدر یا اللہ تو ہمیں نصیب فرما. یا اللہ لیلۃ القدر کے قیام نصیب فرما. یا اللہ ملائکہ جبرائیل علیہ الصلوۃ والسلام کا مصافحہ تو ہمیں نصیب فرما. یا اللہ تو ہمیں نصیب فرما. گھر والوں کو نصیب فرما دے. امت کے حال کو رکھے اوپر رحم فرما. یا اللہ تو امت کے اوپر یا اللہ تو نظر رحمت پھیر دے. یا اللہ امت کے اوپر شفقت کا ہاتھ پھیر دے. یا اللہ پریشانی کو, دکھ کو, تکلیف کو دور فرما دے. یا کریم اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد وعلى آل سيدنا محمد وبارك وسلم وصلى الله على النبي الكريم برحمتك يا ارحم الراحمين.